Hi, welcome to Sagittarius. Thank you so much for watching. Let's see what cards are showing up for you this week and how we can improve your week. So, the World in Reverse, crossed by the High Priestess, Ten of Cups, Nine of Wands, Devil in Reverse, Two of Cups, Page of Swords, Moon, Two of Swords and Three of Wands. Okay, so let's start with the past. After that, we're going to the present. So the date where this video is for, you can see it in the title below. And after that, we're going to take a look on how to improve your week. So a beautiful card to see is the Ten of Cups. So this means happiness. Also, the Page of Swords is about honesty, about speaking up about things. And this is making you probably happy, making other people happy. And the Two of Cups is also that you and someone else, or maybe this is only about yourself, that you find some kind of inner peace, or that you're on the same page with someone. So in the past, Devil in reverse, clarified with the Chariot and the Strength Tarot card in reverse, indicates that maybe you had some kind of fear, maybe you were dealing with certain kind of anxieties. This made you emotionally feel very much overwhelmed. I mean, the Chariot in reverse is about emotional overwhelm, as well as the Strength Tarot card. So emotionally as well as mentally, you probably felt very overwhelmed by anxiety in the past. Also, when it comes to addictions, maybe you stopped a certain kind of substance, the use of a substance, or something that you used that influenced your mood. This is probably you were dealing with in the past. So let's clarify the Chariot. The Chariot is clarified by the Knight of Cups in reverse and the Queen of Pentacles in reverse. So this means that with this anxiety, you start worrying a lot. Maybe you enter some kind of dream world, or maybe you know someone. But I see this card on your side. This is to clarify the Chariot tarot card. So this means that, yeah, maybe this has to do with certain substances. It could also indicate that maybe you're allergic to something that you're eating, or something that you better cannot eat. So the Strength Tarot card for another party, if you are dealing with another party in the situation, the Strength Tarot card in reverse is clarified by the Knight of Pentacles and the Hierophant. So for them, someone maybe have felt a little lusty, or very much, the Devil and the Strength Tarot card could indicate like really like animal instinct, and the Knight of Pentacles is that they were very tuned in into some kind of animal instinct. Maybe they felt that something was off with you. That something was off. Yeah, because something that happened, they thought, okay, this is not normally the way this person behaves. It's probably not the way they behave normally. So yeah, that was something that happened in the past. So maybe there was something like an allergy, a chemical reaction, an addiction, or something that influenced your mood a lot. And it made you feel very dreamy. Also, for example, if you really wanted to win something and you didn't, then maybe you felt this was... I don't see shame in these cards, but I do feel a little bit... maybe you felt like a failure or something like that with something you did. And if there's another party involved, I don't think they see it directly as failure. They see it as a certain kind of fear you're dealing with. So the Ten of Cups, that means that you had probably something very difficult going on in the past, something emotionally and mentally that was just very difficult for you to process. And what I see right now is that during this week you're becoming happy again. You're going to, I think you were going through some kind of, I don't see very much like a spiritual awakening or something like that, because I almost feel like maybe some of you think that this is some kind of spiritual awakening, but it's not. I don't see that. I see the High Priestess here and the Moon more as a lot of illusions, and maybe this is a way to tune into your intuition, but it's not so much as you think that it will really expand your mind or your consciousness or anything like that. It even blurs your consciousness, and maybe you're more busy with your subconscious mind, but this doesn't mean that you are expanding anything, or that you are, because you're still in the same body. Your body cannot, if you grew up in a Western world, it's just what you have been experiencing. You cannot expect, otherwise you would become crazy. And that's also, I think, what happened in the past. So I think for some of you, there's something going on maybe with substances, like hallucinations, or maybe you're suffering from hallucinations or something like that. But I think the Moon is not, it's not clearing up anything. It's even blurring everything that's happening at the moment. So I wouldn't really recommend doing this again or something, or whatever you did. Also when it's about food, eating the wrong foods, this is not good for you. It's definitely not healthy. Because the Moon, it's blurring everything, and the Moon is about emotions and your subconscious mind. And maybe you're discovering your subconscious mind, or maybe you're sleepwalking or something like that. But there's something that you're not aware of. It's not that your mind is expanding and you're becoming someone that, I don't know, is better than the rest or more conscious than the rest or stuff like that. This is more about, stepping into another world, and this kind of world is not necessarily a world that is expanding your consciousness. In a way it does, but when you're back again from this maybe drugs use or whatever you're doing, for some of you it's a huge illusion. So Nine of Wands clarified with the Two of Pentacles and the Seven of Pentacles in reverse. And of course this really depends on maybe who you are, where you were grown up and stuff like that. If maybe you're very close to nature all your life, and so maybe this is expanding something. But what I feel here, there's a lot of blurriness, especially in the past, like an emotional overwhelm, completely in a different world that's not... It's emotional overwhelm, nothing more, nothing less. And just seeing things through pink glasses or black glasses, I don't know. But it's not down to earth at all. No. No, it's just very impractical. So, so what I can see here is that whatever happened in the past, you're recovering from it. And so this is actually pretty good. So you're recovering from this. And this recovery is going very well. The Ten of Cups means that you're very happy with in the relationship or in the situation where you are. And it makes you probably a little friendlier in a way. I think this has to do with fears, honestly. So the world refers to the High Priestess is that you're probably also closing off. You know that this is probably the last time you are going to do something like this. This is not something that... I don't know, it seems to be like a relief for you this week. Something is over, or something is almost over and done. It's a relief for you. So the Page of Swords is clarified by the Hangman in reverse and the King of Swords. Yeah, this indicates you're going to speak up. I think you're very this really emotional part of yourself from the past. You're probably transforming this into happiness. You're going to start to heal, and then you are going to speak up things, but this might be also very honest, but is this the right thing to do for you? So whatever you're saying, is this also in your benefit, or is it only in the benefit of someone else? Because this, whoever you're dealing with, they're very sharp. They have the Knight of the King of Swords. They have the Queen of Cups, someone who's naturally intuitive, and they have the Queen of Swords. This is someone you cannot play around with. So it doesn't really matter. It's more about your happiness, that you're becoming happy and that you are okay at where you are. And not so much about the other people, because they are happy the way they are. And I see very stable people. I see people that are very mature, very analytical, very experienced, very intuitive. So yeah, they know. They know. So there's nothing to hide here. Especially not with your zodiac sign, because that is about speaking up and being direct and being very clear and honest. So there's really nothing to hide. And also, these illusions are not in your benefit, because you like that clarity. That is something, or not you like this, but this is something you're good at. This is a reason why people probably like you a lot. So I get here with the Nine of Wands clarified, with the Two of Pentacles and the Seven of Pentacles in reverse, that you are very careful. But I think there's no need for being careful. I think you can be totally yourself. And I think in the past, this was also something that you have been experiencing, that now you know from yourself that this was what you felt. This is what other people may experience as well. So another time when someone else is experiencing this, you might feel very empathetic, or you know what they're going through. And I see here also that these people you're dealing with, they already know. They might have experienced this as well, or they're not surprised at all. For them, it's like, okay, there we go again. Yeah, there we go again. So there's nothing to hide. It's just the way it is. So that's also what I get in the middle of the week with the Two of Cups, clarified with the Seven of Cups and the Page of Wands. Like, again, you, the people who are watching this, your nature is to be very honest. Even when you try to hide something, people see it. So don't try to hide it. I think here you're the only one with the Seven of Cups, the Moon tarot card. The only person that is fooling themselves by being in an illusion about something. So you're very much, these people know. You can also just ask them if they are keeping you in some kind of illusion, or if they keep you in a certain way that you don't know something. Just ask them, because they know and they will tell you, honestly. Just be very direct with these people. They are very mature. They know, it's you cannot play any games with these people around you right now. So this could be the King of Swords could be a teacher in upright. The Queen of Cups could be someone very intuitive, maybe even psychic, and the Queen of Swords is someone that went through a lot of things, so she's not easily fooled. And that's what I get overall during this reading. So if you are in a situation where you have to hide something, I don't think so. I think this is completing. You don't have to hide it anymore. People know. They all know. Maybe they're even doing research on something right now. They all know. There's nothing to hide here, but there's only something that you are really, really not aware of right now. That you are in some kind of illusion, and the only way to do it is put the page of swords. Just ask, just tell the truth, ask the truth, ask for the truth, ask how things are going. Also, if someone's not contacting you, for example, or you wonder how things are going between you and someone else, this is completely, it's just the way it is. It's not, it's just a normal connection you have with other people. I think you, whatever happened in the past, this was pretty tough, and this was something you were going through, a certain kind of experience that was very intense for your emotions and as well on a mental level. This was so intense, maybe chemicals or I don't know what it is, that in the now you're still recovering from it. You're healing right now. I do see happiness here. Lots of happiness, also stability can be yours, it can be all yours. But just get a little bit grounded this week, because everyone already knows. It's like someone wants to hide something right now and wants to be very careful speaking up about something. Well, everyone already knows. This is almost completed. And you also know it. In a very short time, you get to understand this. Right now, the Seven of Cups is still showing up and the Moon, but your intuition will help you this week. Not substances, not any tools or anything, but just your pure intuition, just yourself. There's nothing needed to get there, nothing. Just your own intuition, tuning into your own intuition. So the Three of Wands is clarified with the Eight of Cups in reverse and the Temperance Tarot card in reverse. This means that, yeah, you are about to walk away from something because they're not putting up with this anymore. They're not putting up with this anymore. I don't know what this is and how. This will be for everyone different who is watching right now. And if you want a personal tarot reading, you're always welcome to click on the link below in the description box to go to my Etsy webshop, and then I will do a tarot reading by email or on video for you. But what I can see here, this is for everyone who is watching right now. And in the end of the week, you will see your ships coming in, and you can just walk away from everything. Maybe you have been, I don't know, maybe even this could be about more people in a relationship. This could be about feeling very much overwhelmed by something or someone, anxiety disorders, psychic problems or psyche problems, or something that you really felt overwhelmed about, but it wasn't really grounded. And you can just walk away from it because there is nothing going on right now. And I see a lot of mature people on the other side, of the tarot cards, that is clarifying the card for the other person. It's like there's a lot of people, if you are searching for help, these people are all around you. They are there for you to help you. So be careful with drugs and, I don't know, alcohol and everything like that this week, because I think really that when I see these cards, it's really needed to get a little bit more grounded and maybe to really heal from why are you doing this in the first place. And this is actually a very beautiful reading, because I do see with here, with the Ten of Cups, there's a lot of happiness. And it's clarified with the Page of Cups and the Queen of Cups. So there's a lot of happiness coming up for you guys. But honesty is really needed. Honesty is needed. And that's also where your strength is. Yeah. So yeah, that's what I can see for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and see you till the next video.